Alien 3 was originally supposed to be the big finale for the series, the disappointing finish to an otherwise awesome trilogy. However, the film was incredibly successful. We've seen so many sequels in these reviews that I think we all know what happened next. Alien Resurrection. The end of Alien 3 saw Ripley sacrificing herself to stop the scientists from keeping the alien queen that was growing inside of her. Alien Resurrection is set 200 years later. Scientists create a clone of Ripley using DNA taken from blood samples from before her death. Of course, this does ask the question, why did they keep her DNA for 200 years? What's the point? They extract the embryo of the alien queen growing inside of Ripley and use it to create alien eggs. I don't know how the DNA of the alien would be in Ripley's blood samples, but whatever. After her DNA gets blended with the DNA of the alien, Ella the Fly, Ripley develops strength from reflexes, acidic blood, and an empathetic link with the aliens. Then the aliens escape and run around killing people on the space vessel. Ripley and a group of mercenaries have to escape the ship. It's a pretty basic plot and is very similar to the original. There is a lot I really like about Resurrection. The acting is really good and the cast is full of famous faces including Winona Ryder, Ron Perlman, and one of my all-time favourite actors, Brad Dourif. Brad Dourif plays a guy who basically has a weird sexual attraction to the aliens and he just overacts the fuck out of this movie. Fans of Brad Dourif going crazy will be incredibly happy with this movie. The film was written by Joss Whedon, creator of Buffy, Firefly, as well as co-writing Toy Story, The Cabin in the Woods, and of course writing and directing The Avengers. His script is actually pretty good. In an interview in 2005, he said that the script was much better than the final film. He said that everything about the film was done differently to how he originally thought it should have been done. I'm not saying the film is bad at all, but yeah, it isn't as good as it should be. The film uses a lot of wide angle lenses, which is something I find really repulsive in films. There is nothing I hate more than the use of wide angle lenses. The only thing I've seen that does them really well would probably be Dead Alive. This movie overuses it and it gets really annoying. The film was directed by French director Jean-Pierre Jeunet. You can definitely tell it was directed by a French director because it has that very European arty feel to it. It is really off-putting at times and it doesn't really fit the tone of the movie. In the film, they introduce a new creature, a xenomorph human hybrid. It looks really awesome. It's probably the most memorable thing about this film. When I think Alien Resurrection, it's probably the first thing that comes to my head. Each film in the series tries to be something different. The original movie is a sci-fi horror movie, the second movie is a massive action movie, the third movie is a combination of the two as well as a bit of a prison drama, and Alien Resurrection is essentially a 90s summer blockbuster. 90s summer blockbusters can be incredibly fun as well as incredibly dumb and cheesy. Luckily, Alien Resurrection blends the two very well. I have problems with the movie, however I still do like it. The film has received mixed reviews, however in recent years more and more people have started to like it, similar to Alien 3. Alien Resurrection is a fun, dumb action film with some surprisingly creepy and disturbing scenes. If you expect it to be anything like the previous movies, you'll be incredibly disappointed. But if you're willing to switch your brain off and just have a good time for a couple of hours, then you'll probably like this movie. I give Alien Resurrection an 8 out of 10.